Hello, Blue Room. My name is Kerli, and you're on the set of my first music video, Walking on Air. Come in.
Once we heard this song, we had an idea that was floating around for some time that we were talking about having an inverted house. And not just inverted visually, but actually inverted conceptually.
Yeah. So everything's flipped around, you know, the windows are bricked in, but you can walk right through the wall to go into the forest, you know?
You know, for example, you have a ceiling fan. Once you pull in the ceiling fan, the fan doesn't spin, but the room spins around the fan and around the person that actually gets to pull it. You know, if there's a kitchen, the fridge is the oven, and the oven is the fridge. So, you know, the fridge is actually fire hot, and the oven is filled with icicles.
I wrote it when I was 17 years old, so it's one of the first songs I ever wrote.
Yeah!
Just a simple touch, just a little glance, makes me feel like flying. Something isn't right. Can you please stop hiding? My name is Kerli, and I'm about to do a mini-series of video blogs here on AOL.com. Throughout these video blogs, I will show you some very bizarre corners of Estonia. You will get to know more about me and my working process. You will also get an exclusive behind-the-scenes look of the making of my new music video for Army of Love, and together we will give birth to Bubble Goth. You know, everybody where I'm from was very poor, so we didn't get to buy any clothes, so my mom made all our things, so I learned how to make all my clothes and accessories from her. And because there's nothing really cool around when I was little, I learned to make, you know, something that I wanted to see out of nothing or very limited materials. I can make a dress out of toilet paper or trash or whatever random I have laying around in my house. And I always show my fans a lot of behind the scenes too, because I don't want them to think that something creative is exclusive to having a lot of money. I definitely wanted to play up the army concept, but I didn't want it to be a regular army because Army of Love stands for the invasion of creativity and beauty. So I decided to take everything army and make the colors into white and pastel colors.
I have this kid's gas mask that I found in LA, and I think I'm gonna bedazzle it.
Within these days of preparation, the lab became a complete hub for all the amazing artists that I had working on the video. On the day of the shoot, we did all the makeup and hair in there, and we always did all the styling and all the gathering, whatever, in there. And all the moon children got transformed into these creatures of the crazy cyber fairy tale we were trying to create. My new album is about to come out next year, very soon. And it's all about overcoming the struggle. I think you guys are gonna totally dig it.
Got me powered up on the double. By the time I released Utopia, I had just like, the life was like beaten out of me. Everyone was like, just make us one normal song, you know, just make us one normal song that we can play on the radio. Just make us one normal video, none of this fantasy character shit, you know. And I was like, okay, okay. And it's just like, I didn't even give a fuck anymore. And then when people were like, yeah, this is like, yeah, it's good quality, but like, what is the self-expression in this? Like, what is the unique artistic value of this? Like, no, there is no unique artistic value. Like, this was made for America, the land of hamburgers.
Walking on air was when I was like super on path, and then I took a whole long detour of just like exploration and not really always following my gut and like listening to a lot of people and trying out a lot of different things.
So many people around me that kind of taught me that this is the way how it's done, and honestly, I just got so sick of it all.
I made some scary decisions for myself and like just quitting everything and like not being a part of like the system in any way and like going independent. Like it was such a scary decision for me to make, and I knew I had to make it, and I'm so grateful that I did, and I'm so grateful that this art is speaking to you.
I came to Estonia and started making some art from my soul again. To be honest with you, when I came to the forest, I feel like I met myself for the first time.
When I came to the forest to cleanse myself, I feel like this right now is the first time in my life where I'm making art, you know, which I sent everything I had made to my last label, and they were like, we can't hear anything, we'd want to release. And I told my manager, well, fuck it, then I can't work with them. Watch me become just an animal, naked to nothing more.
The music video for Blossom is inspired by the most powerful healing plants in my precious homeland Estonia. It is not only a story of survival, but of beating the odds and thriving in the face of obstacles. At the time I was writing this song, I was at a stage in my life where I found myself overcome with a strong calling to reconnect with my roots in order to gain strength. Creating the story from the perspective of a tiny seed growing underground and ultimately bursting through the spring frost to find the sun, Estonia is one of the oldest documented nations in Europe. And one of the most unique things about us is the way we mix modern technology with an ancient way of living in symbiosis with the plant kingdom. It was kind of my approach to marrying thousands of years of tradition with something contemporary, which when you visit Estonia is a theme you'll see played out in every aspect of our life. Because plants are such a natural part of our life, we have a widespread community of extremely knowledgeable healers and herbalists who run their own ecologically sound farms. With all this in mind, I want to take a moment and thank all my dear plant friends for being both a source of healing and providing me with inspiration to create this video. I learned to
about 6,000 years ago, before Estonians had any thoughts about heart or soul or any of these things, they believed that every person has this power, Vaki, that you really have to take care of. So you see this white shamanic character doing all of these rituals, singing songs. She's drumming, she's throwing salt, which is purifying. She's going to sauna, like a futuristic sauna. All of these things that apparently you had to do to take care of your power, Vaki. So that's one of the characters. We also have another character, which is the enemy of Vaki. And that was believed to be the most dangerous thing to your personal power, the evil eye of other people. So we have these evil eye characters that kind of cover that dimension. And in the middle of it, I am caught between the light and the dark. But I don't even know which side wins. You're rolling me in gravel.
I leave without a scratch. You throwing rocks in my way, but I just won't react. The less I see the sun, the brighter I'll become. Outnumbered and outgunned, that's where I'm shining at. My skin is soft like velvet, but my nails are razor sharp. My scent is sweet like honey, but I am diamond.
Oops. I broke Grandma's sewing machine.
It's okay, you have a new one.
Sorry, Grandma, I'm sewing leather pelvis straps.
Oklahoma start hospital hero. Joe, he'll take good care of her. He'll be much better than I.
So it's 4 days before the shoot and building a floral wall, and we want to have like black vines instead of green vines.
Let me see it.
I count my blessings.
Whoa.
Really functions in a way where we're really cut off from the nature. First time I went to live in my nature house, I think I spent there like 7 months at first, kind of like living alone in the nature. The contrast with like the societies living in the city and they're living like that in the nature just felt really, really crazy, because most of the things that people do in their everyday life started feeling like really insane to me. For example, stress, the concept and the feeling of stress. The stress in our bodies is actually designed to like save our life if we're in danger. The stress is not really designed to be experienced just because you wake up in the morning and go about your day. And first of all, to find yourself, you need time. Like, you need to go away where you're not hearing everybody else's thoughts to even get to your own thoughts. And at first I started realizing that my thoughts weren't even my thoughts. And then to get rid of those thoughts and have that like empty space where it's like, well, who am I? Shadow works is actually a psychology term. Carl Jung came up with it. It's about knowing yourself fully, not just about knowing your positive sides, but also knowing all of your demons. And in the beginning, like when you start doing the shadow work, psychologically, really looking at yourself, it's really, really scary. And I realized that me writing all of these songs that were authentic and like negative in a way was actually me doing my own shadow work. And I finally realized that putting this body of work out there in the world is gonna give people a chance to also connect with their own shadow. and to see that, oh, other people are also going through difficult things. Not only is it okay, but it's absolutely necessary to know your own darkness and to own everything that you are. I think a really incredible space, like internally, to get to is where you don't have too much judgment, not on yourself and not on other people.